Laughter is such a pleasant emotion, an expression of happiness and joy that we could all use more of in our day-to-day lives. Unfortunately, if you're like me, then laughter is not something that comes all too easily. I enjoy comedies quite a lot, and when it comes to anime, it's second only to the slice of life genre, but it also takes a lot for something to actually make me laugh out loud, with the majority of comedy anime, whilst still being enjoyable, usually only managing to get a slight smirk out of me, or maybe even a light chuckle at best. So when an anime comes along that is able to make me laugh, it almost always ends up becoming one of my favourites. Enter Angel Densetsu, a 45-minute 1996 OVA based on a manga of the same name and created by Norihiro Yagi, who would later go on to create the popular dark fantasy manga, Claymore. The story is about a caring and naive boy called Seiichirou Kitano, who transfers into a new school with the hopes of making a lot of new friends. Unfortunately, while he's a kind and gentle boy at heart, his sinister appearance often leaves people paralyzed in fear. As he tries his best to reassure those around him of his good intentions, he inadvertently makes things worse. Through a series of events, he quickly manages to take down the boss of the school, ultimately taking his place as the school's guardian, and repeatedly getting into all sorts of problematic situations, thanks to numerous misunderstandings that rapidly escalate. To give you an idea of just how quickly things can escalate, there's a scene in which Seiichirou finds a lost wallet, and so, being the kind-hearted boy he is, wishes to return it. Sounds simple enough, right? Well, it ends up causing a gang war between his school and a rival school. The various misunderstandings that build up to this huge climax are nothing short of hilarious, as one misunderstanding quickly leads to another, and as each of them piles up, the more ludicrous the scenario becomes. One example of just how ludicrous things can get occurs when Yuji Takisa is introduced, a delinquent who had previously been expelled for beating up a teacher. While sitting at Seichiro's desk, Seichirou awkwardly stands there, thinking to himself how best to politely inform Yuji that he's got the wrong seat. But due to his sinister expression, Yuji panics and leaves the classroom. Seichirou then misinterprets this as having greatly offended Yuji and goes after him to apologize. The rest of the class then misinterprets this as Seichirou not forgiving Yuji's indiscretion and wanting to beat him up. This all builds up to a scene outside, where Yuji draws a knife to defend himself, but Seichirou, being kind to a fault, misinterprets this as having offended Yuji to the point of contemplating suicide. And so rushes towards him, screaming, "Don't die," which of course Yuji misinterprets as having murderous intent behind it. I think you get the point. As to whether or not this type of misunderstanding comedy is something you'd enjoy, well, that's hard for me to say, as we all have a different sense of humour. What I find hilarious, you might find boring, and vice versa. So to help paint a better picture of what you can expect from Angel Densetsu, I'm going to briefly talk about two other anime that have a similar type of comedy. Those two anime being Handa-kun and Detroit Metal City. In Handa-kun, you have a protagonist who believes everyone hates him, when in actuality, he's the most popular kid in school, and everyone adores him. This misunderstanding creates a variety of comedic scenarios that, like Angel Densetsu, can jump from 0 to 100 in an instance, starting off as just a simple misunderstanding, and quickly ballooning out of control into something much bigger. Likewise, in Detroit Metal City, you have a soft-spoken boy who dreams of a career in pop, but instead is the lead singer and guitarist of a death metal band, whose overzealous fans often misinterpret his actions as godly acts, and thus creates ever-escalating situations where a simple misunderstanding can lead to something far more serious. Detroit Metal City also has a lot of crude and offensive humour that isn't present in either Handa-kun or Angel Densetsu, which I feel I should point out for anyone who wasn't keen on that aspect of Detroit Metal City. If you enjoyed the comedy in either of these shows, then there's a good chance you'll enjoy the comedy in Angel Densetsu as well. And likewise, if you weren't too keen on them, then this might not be for you. Though, with that said, given that Angel Densetsu can be finished in a mere 45 minutes, there's really no reason not to give it a try, since it's not like it's going to waste too much of your time. I can also happily confirm that Angel Densetsu is the type of anime that's able to remain funny on repeat viewings, as I re-watched this anime prior to making this video to double-check that I still felt the same way about it, and ended up getting so caught up in it while laughing profusely that I forgot to take any notes. Which leads us to the all-important question, where can I watch Angel Densetsu? Well, you can watch the entire thing right here on YouTube. You also don't need to feel guilty about doing so either, because, at present, There is no legal way to watch or support this anime. There is no way to legally stream Angel Densetsu, and there are no DVDs currently in circulation. And if you thought about sailing the high seas, then good luck finding an active torrent, because most of them are long dead. It's such an obscure anime that not even the pirates are willing to keep it alive. This does unfortunately mean that if this anime ever gets taken off of YouTube, not that it's likely to happen anytime soon, given that no one is staking a claim to it, then it will become almost completely impossible to watch. As someone who really enjoys this anime, this pains me a great deal, because it doesn't deserve to be forgotten. It also didn't deserve to only exist as an OVA either. It should have received a full TV adaptation, but sadly it never got one, and likely never will. If you do end up enjoying this anime, then I'd recommend downloading the video, in case it ever disappears from YouTube. Otherwise, you may never get the chance to watch it again.